As far as, you know, this game, this series, and this season, I hope you guys all took notice of what happened in the last 3 minutes of the game. Because, you know, Matt and Vince, they wanted to finish the game. And I think that's what Grizzlies basketball is about. Those guys are pros. And for what we've been through, they've embraced every guy who came in, no matter what their history was. They cared about them. They tried to have them. These guys fought. And I can't tell you enough how proud I am of every guy that is in that locker room and has come through that locker room. This season's been hard. It's been really hard. And I could have quit. Could have not made the playoffs. And every day they came out and they fought like crazy. This was not planned.
And another thing Celtics fans aren't going to want to hear, Marcus Smart. Tremendous opportunity for him to step up with Avery Bradley out of the lineup. And what did Marcus Smart give you tonight? 1 for 11 from the floor, 1 for 6 from 3-point. 3 assists, and was minus 20 for the floor. So Marcus Smart really has 2 more games left. Essentially, assuming the Celtics can win one of these 2 on the road, or otherwise we really have to start to consider him a bust. For the Celtics, we're going to look at Marcus Smart. Was this his signature game that's going to really propel his career? Had some big shots in the fourth quarter. Played some good defense on Paul Millsap when no one else could seem to stop him.
It is a Game 7 in Toronto. These fans north of the border have been clamoring for playoff success. And tonight, one game will decide who advances to the second round. The Indiana Pacers and the Toronto Raptors from here.
His 7th career Game 7. Wire-to-wire victory, and the two terrific coaches.
My friend, yes, feel as they're appointed to death. Keep trying to tell me, all you want to do is use me.
Thunder getting the win, 113-99. They win the series and advance to the Western Conference Finals. They're San Antonio eliminated after a 67-win season. Very tough to be going home when you win that many games. Kevin Durant, there were a few games Kawhi Leonard outplayed Kevin Durant, but for the most part, Kevin Durant showed Kawhi Leonard who the man is in this series. They were basically saying Tim Duncan should retire in this game. I still think he can contribute. He wasn't great in the playoffs. There's certainly games that showed he wasn't all there, so I wouldn't be surprised if he retired, but I don't like them just coming out and outright saying it. Let that be Tim Duncan's decision.
It's the Miami Heat facing the Toronto Raptors in Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Semifinal. Toronto today advancing to the franchise's first ever Eastern Conference Final. It's official now. It's the greatest season in Raptors history.
Our Western Conference Finals preview right now. It'll be the Oklahoma City Thunder against the Golden State Warriors. And showing what they did against the Spurs, I don't doubt this team can go on the road and win a game. I would expect it to be game one.
They're facing Game 5 at a possible closeout Thursday night back in Oakland.
Everyone on ESPN is going to say this series is done, yeah, just like the Cleveland series was done, just like Golden State was going to win this series in 5, so I'm not paying attention to that. I picked Oklahoma City to win in 7. Again, though, Golden State is not finished in this series. You play 3 more games, they have to win all 3, 2 of them are at home.
Stephen A., is it all over?
Well, I believe it is. As much as I want to believe that Golden State will come back and have a game 7, yep, the bottom line is this. I can't see two sharks in Durant and Russell Westbrook. I can't see how they'll pass on chomping them to bits.
Clock to 5. Here's Curry.
Yes!
An MVP can contribute in many ways.
The Golden State. Oh, Curry on the intercept! Runs it out. And that will do it. The Warriors do it by becoming only the 10th team out of 233 to win a best-of-7 series while trailing 3-1.
Don't listen to ESPN because just a couple days ago, they were saying how Golden State had no chance to come back in this series. Eastern Conference Finals would be between the Toronto Raptors and the Cleveland Cavaliers. I like Cleveland in 6 games, but don't expect a sweep and look for Toronto to be competitive.
Love with the right hand. James ahead of the pack. James goes back door. Caps by 13. Irving. Mo Williams, nice pass inside. Eastern Conference Finals, which have been all Cleveland. DeRozan hands it to Lowry. Lowry spins, 4 of 6 from 3. That's just inside. Stolen by Lowry. James in pursuit. Lowry slows down. Oh, back out DeRozan and a new 24. And Casey has to run into the front court to get the officials to see him. And the astounding turnaround continues here in the Eastern Conference Finals. Raptors win a thriller. And the series is tied at 2 games.
Look, everyone just wanted to hand Cleveland the championship, but Toronto has something to say about it. They are not a bad team. They only lost one less game than Cleveland did during the regular season.
James spins, gets in the paint. Left. Irving, shuffle pass. James fakes and finishes. Not a surprise. As Irving again with the Cleveland Cavaliers win the Eastern Conference Final in 6 games. Now advance to the NBA Finals.